You know, we usually don't do this when we switch subjects and are on a different subject, but because of the impact of this story, of this 54-year-old woman, Jacquelyn Smith, and her being murdered, and now the suspects, at least that her indictments are out, are against her 52-year-old husband, as well as 28-year-old stepdaughter. You know, I think it's important if we can get some information to share it. We're joined now by Rob from Harford County, and Rob, according to my producer, shared with us before that he actually knew or knows Mr. Smith. Hello, Rob. How are you?
What's up, C4? How you doing, man?
I'm doing great. Just help me understand. So you know Mr. Smith?
Yes, I do, and I knew Jacqueline as well. I actually called when the first event happened, and you know, I couldn't even get everything out because I was just shaking, crying, trying to talk to you and get it out. But knowing what I know now, we could say, and many people can call in, will say, I knew it, and that's fine. I mean, people can be internet sleuths and all that, and that's great. But everybody who knew Keith, and for people like me who knew Keith and Jacqueline, hearing this news was unbelievable at first. We couldn't believe it. Even if some of the things did seem a little weird, it's like, you know Keith, so it's like, okay, yeah, all right, I get it, I understand. You know, so as the thing started unfolding, the kicker for me was when I found out he was in Texas, because he actually did go to Florida. He was working. He transferred for the company we work for and started working in the other place.
And let me ask you this, Rob. So the story that we're hearing, yeah, that he told Mrs. Smith's brother that he was moving to Florida, that you're saying he actually was down in Florida for a period of time?
Yeah, he was. He was domiciled. He was working. He was actively working. And everything was, you know, going according to plan. And then once I found out this news broke, I had found out that down there that there was some no-call, no-shows happening. And that's when, you know, I lost my breath. That's when it became real for me.
And, Rob, let me ask you this, Rob, because so many people are trying, like I said, it's a gut punch to let people who truly thought what Mr. Smith said was correct. The brother, though, of Mrs. Smith and her mother are now publicly saying they had suspicions of him. Were you aware of any of that?
No, because I didn't know them. I only knew Keith and Jacqueline. Just, you know, I know Keith from work. I worked with him for years.
Okay.
And, you know, we spent some time together. I met Jack. As sweet as they come, as sweet as advertised, and just being around them in a casual sense, you wouldn't think so. But I mean, of course, Jacqueline's family would know better. So you know, I believe everything they say. They've had private and personal conversations,
sure,
with Jacqueline on a level that I never would ever have. So
Can I ask you a question, Rob? Around the people you work with, have you talked to them since this happened yesterday, since the announcement yesterday, the people that
My phone was blowing up, C4. I mean, last time, it got to a point where, I mean, I was just shaking in horror so much that, you know, I had to stop taking calls and texts. I just told people, man, talk to me later. I can't take this anymore, because I was still in shock and disbelief. It's like it happened to me all over again. At first, I lost Jackie. Now I lost Keith.
Hmm.
You know, because it's not the person I thought I was. You know, I thought he was. You know what I mean?
Yes, I do.
And I mean, this is a guy that, you know, I went to the church. I went to the memorial service. I hugged that man and Valeria and told Keith I love him. And if you need anything, I got you. And then I find this out. So you can imagine, like, this is like my heart getting ripped out of my chest once again.
Rob, all I can tell you is I do remember, the more you talk now, I do remember when you called, I do remember how emotional you were trying to talk about this. And all I can say to you, Rob, is that, you know, we think we know people and we don't know. Once those doors close, we don't know what people do privately. I do know this much. If he is guilty, everybody deserves a day in court, Rob. If he is guilty of this, along with the stepdaughter, they're evil, Rob. They really are evil.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I know, and you know, and I walk in my faith, and I know that at this point, as a human and as a Christian, this is, you know, a person I have to let go of my life, and I hope that everybody else can understand that as well. You know, that thing, you never know who you're going to run across in your life, and like you said,
you don't.
What happens behind closed doors, you don't know. And when that comes to light, you got to know, just let that go. I've let him go out of my life at this point.
Well, I just want you to know, Rob, your honesty right now, I just want you to know, a lot of people, I think, are feeling you're in our prayers, as well as the people who have to go through it, because you knew them. We didn't know them. You did. You knew them.
Yeah, thank you, C4.
I appreciate it. I wanted to get that on. I wanted to take that call because, in talking to my producer during the break, you know, this story is one that is going to resonate for a while in our area. And just the whole, the reality coming forward now about these arrests, the fact that Rob and others knew these people and what was on the surface did not appear to him or anybody else to be what we saw. And so it's just, like I say, a shock to the system, and one that really I think talk radio was made for, in terms of letting people in a cathartic way share what is on their mind, and do it in a way where they're not, you know, broken up by commercials and all that stuff as much as TV would, where Rob can share his pain of having first thought that this person he worked with was telling the truth, and now the reality of something being completely different. And the fact they went to church together and they knew each other in church, my goodness.